The thrill from Brazil, world ranked number 6 at only 22 years old, Hugo Calderano, a man of many skills making the game exciting at a global level. Hugo Calderano shattering all records from the Americas. He's 2 times Pan Am Games champion, and he's beaten some of the most unbeaten players on the planet in the last 12 months.
Table tennis for me is like a mental war when you're playing against the opponent. You're very close to him, so you always have to know when to do what, when to make some changes. The small difference in material makes a huge difference on the outcomes.
You need to be very fast, very good physically, but also very strong mentally.
Maybe a little bit stronger than in team sports, because if you win, you're alone. If you lose, you're alone. So maybe the feelings are even stronger.
I'm Hugo Calderano, professional athlete. I'm still very young, I'm 22 years old. My driving force has to be the wish to win and the wish to get medals and to succeed. Because of table tennis, I had many opportunities to travel, to see many kinds of things, and I'm just beginning my career. I'll see even much more, but the experiences I have are some of the most important things in my life. Is my home. I was born there. I lived there until I was 14. Every time I go back there, I enjoy it so much. I enjoy the weather, to be with my family and friends. Yeah, every time my father has time. Of course, he also has to work. But I always ask if he wants to join me to go out and play some sports. Do some fun activities, to go to the beach, and I think I can get a lot of energy from just being 1 week or 10 days back in Rio.
Can you imagine practicing here in the summer?
Oof.
Now it's fall time.
Wow.
Well, I practiced in Rio from 8 to 14. I was practicing just 3 times a week. And not even practicing, I was like playing matches with the guys here. Sometimes I would come to the club and there were 20 people wanting to play. So I have to play a match and go sit down for another 30 minutes, 1 hour, and wait for my turn. Sometimes even the winner couldn't stay on the table because there were just too many people waiting. So both of them or both of us had to go out. Kind of puts your motivation a little bit down because you really can't do much about of your table tennis to improve. So yeah, I was many years just playing like this, playing matches and coming here. And once I was 13, I was already the best player in Rio.
No, it's like this.
Things didn't really happen from day to night to us. We've been living this for many years, so. Originally, I think when he was very young, when he was a kid, we knew that he was very good at sports. We didn't really know which sport he was going to pursue, but we knew he was definitely going to play sports and maybe be a professional athlete. I really don't know when we started to see that this was going to happen. But I think at a certain point, we just started to believe that he could do anything he wanted to. When somebody finally told us he is really good and he can potentially be a very, very good table tennis player, and then we thought it would be okay to let him leave Rio. At the time, it was basically impossible for him to continue developing if he stayed here. He was around 13,
When I decided to follow my table tennis career and to become a professional athlete, I had to move to São Caetano, which was the national training center in Brazil. I started to practice more there. I was practicing 2-3 hours in the morning and the same in the afternoon. I was going to school at night, so my day was pretty full. And I was coming back from school at almost midnight, and my grandfather would wait for me at the window to see when I was arriving, and I was really always really tired, and I just had time to go to sleep and start again next day at 8 o'clock, the same routine every day.
It was very tiring for him. You can imagine a 14-year-old kid with this kind of responsibility, and he would travel a lot to competitions, and then he would stay sometimes 2 months, 3 months away from school. Then when he came back, we would pay for tutors to help him catch up with the subjects.
Actually, when I was 16, I moved to Paris during school, also to practice table tennis. I personally think education is very important. Especially when you are very young, it builds your character and your personality. Of course, sometimes you need to do sacrifices. Be so far from my family and from my country. And there were days that I would just cry at night, I think because I wasn't sure and I was alone. Helped me grow and become stronger as every experience like this. I was 18 when I moved to Ochsenhausen. I had some training camps year before. 1 year before, I came 2 or 3 times, and my coach, Jean-René, he's working really closely to the head coach of Ochsenhausen, Michel Blondel, which is also my trainer, my coach here. He was already in Ochsenhausen. Everything happened naturally. They saw me practicing. They had the idea of bringing me to practice and to play for Ochsenhausen. So everything happened really fast. And I was just happy to have this opportunity to move to Germany and focus on my table tennis.
I think I met him first time was in 2010, during one tournament in Brazil. He was already, let's say, a hope for the country. He had already a quite big potential at this time.
It helps you become stronger mentally if you live in Ochsenhausen. I don't think if I lived in Rio, for example, I'd be as strong mentally as I am today, just because of the atmosphere in the city. It's much more relaxed. You can see the beaches, the view is really nice. And in Ochsenhausen, if you're here, you know why you're here. You have a very strong goal, and it makes you tough, you know. Of course, sometimes I thought about what my life could be if I didn't do it, but I never had a doubt that this was the thing I really wanted and what I had to do.
Ambitious guy, and he wants to push his limits and to try to discover what he is able to achieve, I mean, generally. it's a strong choice to come from Rio de Janeiro to Oxenhausen. But I am even more impressed about, more than the choice, is about how he's acting daily. I think it's really pleasant to see one young guy like this coming from Rio, living in Oxenhausen, arriving to the hall at 8 a.m. morning with big smile, and he's able to enjoy each moment. He knows he has privilege in his life, and this is really nice to see this. There is really interesting contrast between how he is quiet and calm and his determination. And if we transfer this about the game, he is calm and aggressive. And I think this mix is really interesting. Very often, I think in Europe or maybe outside Asia, you can find athletes or players, when they are really aggressive, they can be too exciting or too stressed or too aggressive in a bad way. And I think he has in his personality this really good balance. And we all often say with my friend Michel Blondel, we try to manage and to give direction to him. He's more than a table tennis player. He's like a sportsman. You ask me what he can be in the future. I think he can be really a good ambassador for our sport because his dimension can be bigger than only table tennis.
And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Men's World Cup, the ITTF 2018 Liebherr Men's World Cup. This is the first day of action, and it will be quite exciting. So, Hugo Calderano, one of the top players that people are watching around the world right now wondering, can he take the Men's World Cup? The answer is absolutely. He's shown us before that he can beat the best in the world, and there's no one that is out of his range. And Hugo Calderano takes game number two to tie it up at one game apiece. A dominant performance so far. His job is almost done. Calderano is a very aggressive player, but right now he could be getting a bit cautious. He's close to the finish line, just has to take that step. Tough times right now, score tightening up a bit. Calderano loosening up his chokehold now on Lebesson. He was leading the entire match. This is not over yet. Calderano, can he do it? The time is now, and this is the test. And Lebesson takes it. Calderano must be heartbroken right now. Oh, this is going to be a tough night for Hugo Calderano. Really, the great hope for the world.
Yeah, I couldn't play my best level here. I just couldn't adapt to the match, and unfortunately, I lost. Everybody went through hard periods of time that you don't have such a high confidence, and you don't know if you're capable of doing things. But usually I like to focus on the present and on what I have to do to get better and to improve every day, and not think about the consequences of what if I lose, what if it doesn't work out. My goal is really strong, and I really want to get there as much as anyone in the world to be the Olympic champion. But it's also very important to enjoy the process of getting there.
Every time, I think this is something we joke about this until today, even after he had moved to São Caetano and after he had moved to Germany, every time he came back home, I kept asking him, are you sure you want to continue? Are you sure you don't want to stay and give everything up? Because it's like I wanted to make sure that he knew that for us, whatever he decided, it would be okay. And then it was like he was always reaffirming his commitment and his passion, and that was really what he wanted to do. So every time he came, and then I asked, do you want to stay? Do you want to give everything up? No, bye-bye, I'm going. And then it was it. And then for us, it was okay. So he doesn't feel sorry. I don't think he has ever felt sorry for himself. It's a sacrifice, yes, but so many people in the world have hard lives. So if you are so lucky to be able to live doing something you love and be healthy and make money out of it, so there's really nothing to complain about. And this is something that the whole family, it's an idea that the whole family shares. My husband always told him from very early, your opponent as a person is more important than the game. So this is something that he has in mind. Of course, the family values, I think, had some impact. But I think mainly it's confidence that comes from within, and he has it. Of course, being good at what you do helps boost your confidence, and then it's a cycle, right?
Many times people ask me, how do you teach him table tennis? But I have to say, if I am honest, probably he's teaching me more than I am teaching him. My mission is to guide him. I think Hugo is successful, and I hope he will not stop here. He will have next steps, because there is a big concurrence, and let's see what will happen. Something I am very proud about what he's doing, and of course he can be proud about this, is he's always following his own way. This is true about his own life, but this is also true about his game. I mean, it's not so often when we go out from one defeat, when we are really frustrated, because he can lose because the opponent player is better, or he can lose because he didn't succeed to impose his own game. But every time he will make a choice, and he will go 200% in this choice. And I think this is really one important concept to succeed in high level. I mean, you need to have a strategy and to follow this strategy to make your dream becoming a reality. And finally, the most important is not the final result, but the way that you are taking. If you like and if you love this way, I have the feeling that you can have a really nice life. And this is what we have today, and that's why I hope this will continue for a long time.
Good pressure here on the receive from Fang Zhendong over the table. His Chiquita is very strong, his backhand receive. 7-3 serves with Fang Zhendong. Sky lob. Rackets twiddled. Backhand counter. Two. Oh, and he misses the short side. Fang Zhendong takes the points. That being said, tough to return. So hard keeping it in play from deep in the backcourt. Timeout on Fang Zhendong's side.
Santa de entrar com a esquerda de minha
recepção.
Sim, mas mesmo que você perdeu o primeiro ponto 9-9, foi muito interessante de fazer.
A primeira resposta foi muito bom.
Right into the body again. These reactions we're getting. 6-6. And the float serve gets a long push off the table. Calderano 1 point ahead. Just blowing off that cool ball toss hand. Second serve. Match point for Hugo Calderano. The thrill from Brazil does it. Hugo Calderano takes down world number one. Latin America, the Americas, and the rest of the world. What a performance. World ranked number 6. Hugo Calderano has beaten the most unbeaten player on the planet. The most dominant player of 2018.
I've had, of course, some very tough moments, but it's very important to keep cool, to know the process is long, to have a global view, to have a big confidence on what you have to do and what you're doing daily. But of course it can be shaky sometimes, even if it's not now, even if it's not in 1 year, 2 years, you get where you want.
I'm Hugo Calderano, and this is my story.